Next on Jonathan Bird's Blue World, Jonathan visits a city full of stingrays.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Bird, and welcome to my world.
The Stingray. It sounds like a weapon from outer space. It even looks a little like a spaceship, but actually it's a flattened fish with wings, a close relative to the shark. But stingrays are almost never dangerous to people because they spend most of their time on the bottom of the ocean hunting for clams and worms in the sand. Southern stingrays live all over the Caribbean.
And nowhere are they more common than here, Stingray City on Grand Cayman Island. This is one of the most famous marine animal encounters in the world.
The Cayman Islands are just to the south of Cuba in the Caribbean Sea. These islands are a diver's paradise with lush reefs and amazingly clear water. But it's not just divers who come here. Each day, dozens of cruise ships come to the Caymans loaded with tourists. Many of them come to interact with the stingrays, and that's why I've come here. My guide will be artist and marine biologist Dr. Guy Harvey, who operates a shop here on Grand Cayman Island. I stopped by to get a look at some of his famous paintings of marine life. Dr. Harvey takes a few minutes to show me his technique and his famous signature.
Probably one of the most...
Great. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you guys doing today?
Great.
How about you?
And then early the next morning, well before most ordinary tourists are awake, with Dr. Harvey and his daughter Jessica as my guides, I head out to Stingray City in hopes of observing hundreds of stingrays schooling in formation.
Well, Jonathan, hopefully there'll be nobody out there when we get there and we can observe this phenomenon of the schooling stingrays, this is the only place in the world you'll see it happen.
Stingray City itself is a series of shallow sandbars on Grand Cayman's North Sound. When we arrive and drop anchor, there's nobody else here.
It's pretty deep.
I'm in the water for just a few minutes when, off in the distance, a squadron of stingrays comes right at me. We have the stingrays to ourselves for a while, but soon enough, other people start to show up. By mid-afternoon, hundreds of tourists have arrived to experience direct contact with the stingrays. The stingrays come here not for the contact with people, but for the never-ending buffet. The tourists, like all good guests, always bring something for lunch. A little fish or squid, for example. By feeding the stingrays, humans have actually altered their natural history here in the Caymans. Normally, they're nocturnal animals, feeding at night and resting during the day. But things are different at Stingray City, as Dr. Harvey explains.
By feeding them all day long, what we've done is change that. They go to sleep at nighttime because they don't need to forage, and they come here in the daytime. So the whole deal arrangement of behavior, feeding behavior, has been altered.
You could never do this with a truly wild stingray. These stingrays have been fed, and they're used to people, and they're not afraid. Normal stingrays, they take off, but these guys are looking for a little bit of a handout. So that's not really the only reason we can get this close to them. But still, the interesting thing is they are wild animals. They come to this place to be fed, but so do the animals that eat them. So they can become victims of shark bites, they can get hit by boats, cut up by propellers. So it's a pretty dangerous place still, even though it looks like it's just an aquarium. They don't call them stingrays for nothing. That's the stinger, or a barb. It's just a really sharp spine at the base of their tail, and it's their only means of defense. When they get attacked, it's the only thing they have is a little poker.
They use their stinger to protect themselves from their predators, sharks.
You know, for a big shark, this is like coming to Burger King.
And this is a perfect example, because this male has lost his tail and half a clasper, probably to a shark. But he's doing all right. He's doing all right.
All right, we'll let him go.
The key to catching him, so I'm told by the experts here, is you gotta get in front of him. But they keep turning on me. Okay, here we go, here we go, here we go. Up, turning. Here we go.
There you go.
There we go. No, don't turn, don't turn, don't turn, don't. He just jumps right in there.
It's
like wrestling an alligator.
This is a big one.
You ready? You ready?
Yeah.
No, I gotta catch him myself.
Right.
Whoa!
That is a big one.
Hello! That's a love bite. The most important part of this is to keep their head underwater, because obviously they can't breathe if you lift it out of the water. Jessica has a good example here for you. If you look on the stingray right behind the eye, there's a giant hole. You might think it's the gill, but it isn't. It's called a spiracle, and it's a little place where they can inhale water and then they pump it down into the sand through their mouth. And what they do is they use it like a jet. They blast little holes in the sand to hunt for prey.
Yep, so people wouldn't tell this.
Oh, no,
there's a little piece of fish. Little piece of fish we got going here. And it smells quite fishy. Here you go. Whoa, hey, yo, take it easy. There's a lot of inhalation going on that.
There's a lot to learn about stingrays, and Dr. Harvey leads a group of scientists who capture, measure, and tag the stingrays to learn about the impact of human interaction. They inject electronic chips into them so they can study them over many years. Since the tags go under the skin, they never fall off, and they don't interfere with the stingray's natural behavior.
It works. We got 100% tag retention, which is really good for a long-term study on a population like this.
Dr. Harvey's research has shown that the same individual stingrays stay here year after year, and the bigger, more aggressive rays tend to get more food from people, so the smaller ones still have to do a lot of their own foraging. He also found that predators like sharks keep the population of stingrays under control. As for the human impact, it seems that both humans and stingrays enjoy the interaction. They both get something out of the deal. There is no doubt that Stingray City is special, a magical place where the creatures of the ocean and those of the land can meet and find common ground.